out to Lysiak. He's got an open man on the left court, but reading that play and blocking it off at center ice was Jim Neal. And Neal is drilled from behind by Hutchison, and there they go. I think Hutchison was going to pick up an early charge or cross-checking, and there may be more. So we have our first penalties of the night. All jamming up directly below us at the Hawk player bench.
Well, definitely Hutchison will get 2 minutes more because he did cross-check along the boards and then went into the boards and started something with Neal. And we have also Higgins and Campbell looking at each other and pushing and shoving. That's a difficult job of a linesman like John D'Amico when several other things break outside the original practice. And there you see two heavyweights right there, Al Secord and Curt Frazier. Both those fellows can handle themselves very well.
And Van Helleman doing it early, I think he's waved them both off, and I think in that situation, Keith, it could be 10-minute misconducts. In fact, they're being taken to the dressing room. I wonder if he's given them game misconducts to make sure that we don't have any turmoil. As Bannerman was sprayed by Murray, who quickly came out of that corner to help, as the Hawks getting caught now with mistakes in front of their own net. Working along the near side, Doug Wilson tries to fall on the puck, and the Hawks tie it up desperately in their own left wing side. We've played 12-32 in a brisk, exciting first period, and with all the skating and shots, the shot total 6-4 Vancouver. We're tied 1-1. Preston trying to work inside Gradin in the offensive left wing corner. He's tied up. Boy, Mulvey has really run out. By snaps, they all go down in a pile in the corner to the right. A goaltender, Brodeur, and Andy Van Helleman has not stopped play. Now he does finally, and steps very, very close, perhaps over the borderline for a charge. On the right wing, Rhoda's got Smeal breaking for the net. And the headman's on the stride too far forward. And oh, bully, as he tried to block it off, slid heavily into the goalpost, and I think he also took down Bannerman, and the Hawks have hurt two players. Bannerman writhing in a bit of anguish in the goal crease, and Bully has yet to move to the right of the net.
I didn't really see what happened there, Gene, because I was following the puck come out the other side. But there we have Skip there. Now Doug Wilson moves on Darcy Rhoda here, and Rhoda throws it across the middle, and Ted Bully falls down of his own accord and goes right into the goalpost, and Murray Bannerman tries to slow down his particular speed there. Rhoda is going, throws the puck across, and Ted Bully falls down and goes right into the goalpost. And that's the bad thing about those goalposts. They don't give much. And, you know, whether that would have been Murray Bannerman or Brodeur, they both would have tried to stop that player coming with that kind of speed into the goalpost.
Finally, minutes now, Secord pushes at Big Harold Steps, and they're quickly separated. And all the players quickly skate out to make sure that nobody has a numerical advantage.
And this is something I really don't like to see, Gene, when everybody empties the bench at the end of a period and gets involved in a bunch of pushing and shoving, because things could break out here that could really mar the game. It's been a good game so far, good skating, good hitting, and certainly some good plays made for the different goals on each team. And you don't like to see this. I hope the referees and the linesmen break it up and move each team to their dressing room.
Well, that's where all the fireworks start when you have all those players belling, because all it takes then is one push or one word, and then it explodes. Of course, I wouldn't know about that in Philadelphia.
No, that's true. It doesn't happen there very often.
No.
And of course, you're never criticized for anything. The Flyers are not criticized by the league at all for anything
like
that.
Look at this year. The Flyers were last in penalty minutes in the playoffs. Montreal first, which shows you what an odd year it's been.
Sure.
All right.